Alright, so yeah, I know we're hyped over the Fab Four that I found, the giant swallowtails, the caterpillars. Now, and like all night I'm like, oh gosh, I can't stand it, because now the total stranger knows that they exist, they're not safe there on that tree, and so I'm like, now I have to move them, don't I? Because they were out very public, just 5 feet from the curb, from the sidewalk, and so I'm like, it's too dangerous, I don't have a fence, they're not fenced in. So I took them off the tree and I put them on other orange trees that I have. And then I'm like, well, I'm changing nature, because the mother, you know, planted her eggs there. She wanted them there in that spot specifically for a reason. You know, she didn't want them in at the other trees. I had the other trees and she could have chosen those, but she didn't. So, but I had to alter her wishes. You know, I had to alter nature's wishes. Her instinct was that was the best location. Okay, so since then, now I've moved them to separate trees, and so now I've split up the siblings. The four siblings were all split up, given different trees. Now, unfortunately with this, today it's rained all day, and they're like, well, now what? You know, I'm just like on pins and needles, how are they doing? And I have one that's completely disappeared, meaning a bird most likely has taken it away. So I may have lost one completely. Now I have three. So now they're dropping, aren't they? They're like dropping. Now I only have three of these giant swallowtails. And this is just the beginning, you know. They have a big life to live in their cocoons, you know, and hopefully make it to that stage. This is a tragedy. It's a tragedy. Okay, so now I have one that is not doing very well. And he's absolutely just not moving. No budge. Like, that's it, he's given up. So the move did not go well. So I have one that's just completely given up, and I have two others that are still clinging on. So, yeah, why couldn't the person just shut up and just not be a hassle? Because now I'm freaked out, you know, maybe they were poisoned in the night. Maybe the jerk came back and squirted them with poison. You know, people are psycho over pesticides, and they see something that looks like a slug, you know, they're gonna kill it. They're just psychos. So now I'm in a devastation here. I've gone to four, and it looks now like I'm dropping off to two if the third one doesn't make it. So anyway, so all I can do is apologize to the mother, because she probably knew that back where I put that one, a bird would get it quite quickly, and that's most likely what happened. So anyway, it's a fragile world, isn't it? It's a very fragile world for these little creatures. I'm devastated. I'm devastated by their death, you know. Even more so than humans anymore, it seems like. The humans, they are getting their 100, for the most part. A lot of them are getting their 100 years. A lot of them are getting quite a long life. And they're being, you know, they're very lucky in that. But these little animal creatures are not getting long lives. We have loggerhead turtles that are, I don't know if it's specifically the loggerheads, but they're supposed to live like 1,000 years. And it's just like a stop going on. you know, because of garbage. They're eating garbage that's being dropped off of boats and shipped out of islands, and that's filling up their stomachs with all this plastic. And so they only get so big, you know. They never really get to full maturity. And so we're just killing all of them because of plastic and the pollution thrown into the water. And the water apparently is so gross and filthy with all of this pollution that they eat it and they starve. They literally starve. So it's a starve moment in the system where the system is blocked. Like it can't get the nutrients through, and so they starve to death. Even though they try to eat, they just starve to death. So it's like when you see like people that are grossly overweight, they are nutritionally starved. And so thusly they have to eat more and more to compensate. And so it makes their weight become, I have to gain weight in order to be healthy, you know? So it becomes like a real tough battle for them to back off all of that and just, you know, like, you know, drink like real nutrition drinks only, that are just, you know, really super foods rather than regular style foods. Yeah, so anyway, dang it. That's my sad of the day so far. I don't know how to help those turtles out there off the Cayman Islands. It's just the saddest thing ever. They make so many too. They make so many little tiny little turtles, you know, that come out of their eggs. They make so many, but then they have heaps of garbage that they have to walk over to even get to the ocean, and they don't make it. They die along the way. They can't even get from the sand to the water because there's so much garbage in between, you know, that's washed up on the ocean. It's just killing, you know. They're just, how could people be so destructive? They're so lazy. They can't take their garbage off their boats and take it to the moorage places. They're that lazy. It costs money to throw the garbage away normal, so they throw it overboard. That's what we're dealing with. We're dealing with people like that all around this world, you know, and they're standing in line next to you at the supermarket. Just a bunch of evil people. Anyway, yeah, it's tough. A person was saying, talking about greed and the removal of greed and how we can remove it. Well, these greedy people are selfish. They're so self-centered and so self-oriented. My life, my doom. Oh, look at my show-off action. That they don't care the killing. They don't care the upset, they don't care the extinctions. Just immatures, greedy immatures all around us.